We skip to the part where Sam is working as a drive-thru manager at a local McDonald's near Waterford Lakes Village. Okay, here I go. Fellow greetings and welcome to this humble hamburger paradise, known worldwide as McDonald's. We serve all kinds of hamburgers, cheeseburgers, and quarter pounders. How may I serve you in this drive-thru counter?
I would expect better from you, McDonald's, except you being so noble like a knight in shining armor. This isn't medieval emblems, you goof.
Sorry, I just like my job here. Anyways, how may I serve you today?
I would like 2 Big Macs, a quarter pounder with cheese, and 2 orders of your 6-piece chicken McNuggets, please. And I would like that to go.
Dude, you sure you're going to order that much food? A Big Mac has 550 calories. If you add a quarter pounder with cheese and 12 pieces of chicken McNuggets in total, that will add up to 3,240 calories, making you more fat than ever. Well, since Buddy Hackett, either cut the 2 Big Macs or the quarter pounder with cheese, and you'll be all set.
Gosh dang it! Every time I go to a fast food restaurant, there's always that food calorie rubbish. I don't want to be treated like such. And Buddy Hackett wasn't fat, that's just the way he was. Because of your remarks about what I ordered, I'm taking my services to Burger King instead. Goodbye!
Jeez, that customer seemed to have binge-watched too much Little Mermaid. Sure, I've watched it many times, but he has to watch any other movie besides The Little Mermaid. Why not Car 3? It's action-packed.
Sam, you know we do not tolerate food calories in McDonald's. You know we cook double cheeseburgers long enough to cure any disease that will make them feel better in any way. Just like when we cook French fries in order to help stop the coronavirus.
Hey, that's what the 2 Big Macs and a quarter pounder with cheese do to them. They'll get fat, much fat like Buddy Hackett, when he plays the voice of the seagull, known as Scuttle.
We do not mention the name of Buddy Hackett in vain here, you know by now that he died on June 30th, 2003, remember?
Whoops. Sorry about that. Okie dokie, here comes my next customer. Here I go. Hello, and welcome to McDonald's. How may I serve you today?
Hi, I would like 4 McDoubles, all of them with no pickles, and a Filet-O-Fish meal, please.
That's it? Nothing else?
Yes. That's all what I ordered.
Okay, that will be $16.75. Your food will be ready at the next window. Please proceed there.
Here is my money. Thank you for your service, sir.
Thank you, and here is your food. Thank you, and have a nice day. Wow, I think this turned out pretty well.
Indeed, Sam. If you keep this up, you'll be the best there is.
Next customer. I gotta do this very quick. I got no time to waste. Hello, and welcome to McDonald's Hamburgers. What can I order for you today?
Hello, I would like 35 double cheeseburgers, all of them with no pickles, 20 Big Macs, a small strawberry shake, 10 spicy deluxe crispy chicken sandwiches, and 45 whipped chickens with Cajun sauce, please. And make it quick and snappy. My brother is throwing a party starting at 10 minutes time, and I haven't got all day, you know?
Whoa, hold up, are you going to order that much food? Too much food will make you even more fat than Buddy Hackett when he appears in The Music Man. Note that the movie is from Warner Brothers and not Disney. Also, why is your little brat of a brother throwing a party in your house? It absolutely makes crud sense.
Sam, I already told you we do not mention Buddy Hackett's name in vain. It always unsatisfies the customers.
Oh, my motherly God, in the name of Jim Cummings. What do you think I'm ordering all this food for? My brother's friends, cousins and relatives need that food to help organize his family reunion, and I don't have the time to be wasted by your crude remarks.
Also, what you ordered costs $800,441.55. Seriously, do you really need that much food? If you're gonna organize your brother's family reunion, you definitely don't need that much food. I suggest you consider improvising and cut the double cheeseburgers, Big Macs, McChickens, and spicy deluxe crispy chicken sandwiches for crying out loud. Why not give your friends 15 McDoubles and 10 chicken McNuggets for a change, but keep the small strawberry shake.
You know what? I think that'll make a great improvisation. Okay, I would like 15 McDoubles, 10 chicken McNuggets, and the small strawberry shake, please.
Okay then, that'll be $31.77. Your food will be ready at the next window. Please proceed there.
Thank you so much. Here is my money.
And here is your food. Have a nice day, and enjoy your brother's family reunion.
Nicely done, Sam. Except for the last two orders, you've multiplied their orders, which makes it more complicated. How about you just concentrate on adding the price of the food first, then adding the number of orders they pick. It'll be much easier than just adding the price and multiplying the number of orders they chose.
Okay, I got it. Oh look, here goes my next customer. Welcome to McDonald's, where we provide you with speedy service. How may I help you?
Hi, I would like 5 orders of double bacon quarter pounder with cheese, 5 double cheeseburgers with no pickles, 2 orders of your 6-piece chicken McNuggets, and a small caramel latte, please.
Hum hum. Your voice sounds familiar. You kind of sound like that bacon-obsessed guy who liked all things bacon. When you said, double bacon quarter pounder with cheese, you're kind of referring to bacon, right?
Sir, you know I don't talk like bacon does. Would you like it when I order 5 double bacon quarter pounders with cheese, 5 bacon McDoubles, and 5 bacon egg cheese biscuits? No, not at all. I only came here to eat healthy to lower my calories. Not to eat all things bacon, you know?
Sorry about that, I was only talking about bacon, in the Sam Joe universe. Anyways, that'll be $25.38. Please proceed to the next window for your food, it'll be ready.
Thank you so much, sir. Here is my money.
And here is your food. And you have a nice day.
Very well done, Sam. And I like how you referred to bacon when you heard him say 5 double bacon quarter pounders with cheese. Sure, his voice looks familiar, although he talks different than bacon.
I know, right? I guess I know better Sam Joe references than Mary, don't you think so? Anyways, here comes my next customer. Hello there, and welcome to Ollie's Food Bargain Outlet, where good stuff like McDonald's come done cheap. How may I be of assistance today?
Bah, I thought this was a place for cheeseburgers and chicken nuggets, not bargains and cheap stuff. Very disappointed at the slightest. I'm taking my services at Red Robin Gourmet Burgers and Brews instead. Goodbye.
Sam, you should concentrate better on how we qualify for food services to the customers, not bargains that will come down cheap. This isn't Ollie's Bargain Outlet, if you're referring to bargain stores. This is McDonald's, and you should treat your customers with respect.
Got it, Chief. Next customer, here I go. Welcome to McDonald's, where we treat everyone with respect. How may I be of dutiful assistance today?
Hello, I would like 3 orders of your bacon McDoubles, and 4 small French fries, please.
Okay, that'll be $11.38. Proceed to the next window, please.
Thank you, and here is my money.
Here you go. You have a nice day. Wow, that customer seemed very nice. He reminds me of Phil Harris, a world-renowned singer and actor who did Thomas O'Malley in the Aristocats.
Ha ha ha, nice one, Sam. You know, we've been to Indiana this year, and I think that reference you put in clearly shapes up my summer vacation.
I know, right? Here we go, on to the next customer. Hello, and welcome to McDonald's. How may I help you?
Yes, do you have any chicken sandwiches?
Why yes we do, Sir Topomet. We have spicy chicken sandwiches, by the way.
In that case, I'd like 3 orders of them, please.
Okay, that'll be $6.99. Kindly proceed to the next window, please.
Here's my money.
Thank you, and here is your food. You have a nice day, Sir Topomet. Alrighty then, my next customer is here. Hello, welcome to the Golden Arches, aka McDonald's. How may I satisfy you today?
Hello? Do you have any cheeseburgers on stock?
Yes we do, Boo. We also have McDoubles, double cheeseburgers, and bacon McDoubles.
In that case, I'd like to have four of them without any pickles. One for me, one for Tigger, one for Piglet, and one for Eeyore.
That'll be $6.39. If you may, proceed to the next window.
Thank you ever so much. Here's my money.
Here is your food, Winnie the Pooh. Have a nice day. All right then, next customer. Time to do this. Welcome to McDonald's. How may I help you today?
I just drove all the way to find a fast food restaurant, and boy am I starving for four quarter pounders.
Well, Goofy, you've come to the right place. And your order will be $8.89. Proceed to the next window, please.
Here's my money.
Thank you. You have a nice day. And here comes my next customer. Hello, and welcome to McDonald's. How may I take your order today?
By leaving this establishment, set foot on Indianapolis, Indiana, because you're fired.
Huh? I don't understand. What do you mean by leaving McDonald's on Indianapolis, which is too far up? And what do you mean I'm fired?
Multiple reasons. Being rude to the customers, multiple vandalisms, too much SJW influences, butchering our name too many times, I could go on. And our restaurant is being flooded with negative reviews. Now get out of here, before I get the police to catch you red-handed.
Don't listen to him, Sam. That customer you're talking to is nothing but a scam. Hang up the phone immediately, and proceed to the next customer.
I'm on it, Chief. Here comes my next customer. Welcome to McDonald's. How may I help you?
Just wondering, do you have any quarter pounders in stock?
Yes, we do, impersonator of Buddy Hackett. We also have double bacon quarter pounders with cheese.
In that case, may I have two of those, please? I also would like to have fresh water with it.
That'll be $8.38. Please proceed to the next window.
Here's my money.
And here is your food. You have a nice day. Oh my gosh, another customer. Hello there, and welcome to McDonald's. How may I help you?
Hello, I'd like to have 8 orders of your McDoubles, 15 orders of your quarter pounder with cheese, 20 McChickens, and 40 Big Macs, please.
Sorry, sir, but like what I said to the customer earlier, a Big Mac has 550 calories, and too much Big Macs may cause you to get fat, much fat than Buddy Hackett, when he plays the voice of Pardon Me Pete, from Jack Frost of Rankin Bass.
What the heck? Every time I order food in a fast food restaurant, you complain about food calories and compare me to Buddy Hackett, which your chief told you not to. If I ever hear any more remarks about food calories and comparing me or any customer to Buddy Hackett, your behind is out of this restaurant. You know what, forget this, I'm taking my services to Cheddar's Scratch Kitchen instead. Goodbye.
Wow, another Little Mermaid obsessor caught me off guard.
Sam, how many times have I already told you we do not answer to the name of Buddy Hackett in vain?
Sorry, Chief, but every time I run into a customer who orders too much, I compare them to Buddy Hackett, when eating all of their food.
Sam, if I hear one more remark about comparing others to Buddy Hackett, which you're not allowed to say his name, your sorry excuse is out of this restaurant because of your unsatisfactory opinions.
Okay, Chief, you don't have to yell. Anyways, next customer. Hello, welcome to McDonald's. How may I help you today?
Nothing, because three words, you are fired. And the main reason why is, multiple reasons, remarks about food calories, bad knowledge about food prices, mentioning the name of Buddy Hackett in vain, complaining about ordering much food, bad behavior towards customers, bashing other people's opinions, bad improvising, gross attitude towards customers, I could go on. By marching straight out of this restaurant in a lafayette, you are also banned from this McDonald's forever. We will not tolerate your rude behavior in my restaurant. I am very appalled by your horrible actions.
What? Please tell me this is all a scam.
This is no scam, sir. What the boss of this restaurant said is all true. You can't get rid of comparing people to Buddy Hackett just if they order too much food, can you? I'm afraid I have no other choice but to ban you from this McDonald's and any other McDonald's across Florida, Pennsylvania, and Virginia. Ronald McDonald is very disappointed of your actions, and now he's putting you on the blacklist. Get the heck out of this restaurant right now or you'll be facing some time in the Ridicule!
No.
Don't listen to them, Sam. All of this is a hoax. It's all not true. Besides, you have our next customer pulling up in the drive-thru already.
Be quiet, Chief Supervisor Mike. Sam is no longer needed of your assistance. Now, Sam, I'm giving you 5 minutes to get the heck out of this McDonald's. Get up now.
Hey, you let go of me. I'm an innocent person, I tell you. Innocent by heart and by the mercy of God.
You think you're innocent, but you're not. Now, out of this McDonald's and go straight back home. Now. 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 Now.